the Rocker 106.1 Kiss FM alongside, as always, my tag team partner.
What's up? It's Eric Cornish with WKDQ, ready for a Royal Rumble week here with the Enhancement Talents. One of my favorite pay-per-views.
I would say always delivers the good. The Rumble is always one of my favorites. Rumble and WrestleMania, of course, are the big two in my opinion. This is our first Royal Rumble as a podcast.
That's right, and we're getting closer and closer to that 1 year anniversary. We'll have to plan something big for that.
I think so too. This is a very big deal, and a lot of positive memories from the Royal Rumble. I can tell you that my first Royal Rumble that I got to see live or in general was in 1995, and if you remember that year, Pamela Anderson was the focus of the show.
I would tend to point at 1995 to say maybe the worst Rumble of all time, in my opinion. So you picked a bad one to start off on. And not because of the outcome or anything like that. It just, if you look back and look at all of the entries, there was a lot of tag team entries, and those automatically disqualify each other, you know, back in the day. And it was just, and it was the shortest Royal Rumble of all time, too.
There were a lot of people I didn't know who they were in that Rumble, because I had been watching since SummerSlam, but I've been watching pretty faithfully. I had no idea who Greg Valentine was.
Yeah.
I just remember being confused, like, who is this? And I believe they even imported some, like, no-name guys to be a part of it, too. But, yeah, it was kind of a strange Rumble. That was the one that kicked off the Lawrence Taylor feud, if you remember.
Yes, yeah.
The tag team tournament finale. There was a Bret Hart-Diesel match that wasn't bad. It ended in, like, a disqualification kind of deal. But, yeah, it wasn't great. Nothing to write home about.
My first Royal Rumble was actually the very first one, the one that was live on USA, 20-man Royal Rumble, won by Hacksaw Jim Duggan. I do remember watching that event. That was a big deal.
I've watched it, but only on the network or on the on-demand channel.
No great outcome of that one, but I thought that was interesting. The first two Royal Rumbles ended very strangely because, I mean, all the Royal Rumbles after that set up something very major. But, like, Hacksaw Jim Duggan winning the first one and then the second one won by Big John Studd really didn't set up a whole lot.
Well, it was still new and it wasn't, like, epic at the time. Didn't the first one have, like, a weightlifting competition?
Yeah, Dino Bravo and his attempt to break the world record bench press, getting a little help from Jesse Ventura. You know, that was, you know, it was interesting.
If you're looking at the Rumble as a show and not just a match, I think by far the best Royal Rumble is 2000.
Okay.
2000 had an amazing match with Triple H and Cactus Jack.
Yep.
If you remember that with the thumbtacks and everything.
Yeah.
The Dudleys fought the Hardys in Madison Square Garden. There was some sort of Diva strip-a-thon where they all take their clothes
May
off.
Young, yeah.
And a cool Rumble. Just a great time in wrestling, in my opinion.
Yeah, and then...
Oh, the debut of Taz with Kurt Angle.
That's true. Debut of Taz. And then, of course, you also had it was very funny. You have funny moments in the Royal Rumble, but Kai and Tai coming back in, and then the replay over and over again
of his face getting smashed.
Of just the face plant from Funaki and Lawler laughing about it. Was really funny.
Oh, I miss those times.
And then, of course, the ending with Rock getting the victory with Big Show and that turning into the four-way at WrestleMania 2000. But, yeah, that was a really good Royal Rumble.
I was at the Raw after that Royal Rumble in Philadelphia.
Very cool. Some of the moments you have to look at, like Kofi Kingston, I mean, it's almost like, what's he going to do every year?
Not win.
No, not win, that's for sure. But
steal the show.
That's fine. He will steal the show, and he will, save elimination somehow. I thought that's always something that people look forward to these days. One of the best eliminations I ever remember. Remember when Snitsky eliminated Paul London? Do you remember this?
It's not ringing a bell.
It was an amazing elimination as Paul London gets thrown over but lands on the apron. Snitsky, you know, throws a clothesline, he ducks it, turns back around, and then hits a clothesline. Paul London turns a backflip and lands on the floor.
That's cool.
That was a cool elimination.
Other memorable eliminations include, was it Butchwacker Luke in like 4 seconds?
Yeah, just whacked in and whacked out.
Santino whacked in and whacked out. Drew Carey has a memorable run in the Royal Rumble.
If you would like to say that.
What about, here's one for you, what about Maven and Undertaker?
That was cool. Technically, Maven's still in the Royal Rumble.
Yeah, technically that match is still going on.
I'm still waiting for the day where Maven just slides in and goes, I was never eliminated.
Don't you ever wonder what he's up to?
Last I heard, he was a host on QVC.
Is he really?
That's what I heard.
You know, I can see him doing that.
Yeah, so congratulations, Maven. And speaking of Maven, you can catch Maven on the WWE Network first season of Tough Enough, now uploaded there.
I think that's cool, by the way. I hear it's coming back, and that makes me really excited.
That may be the only place you can see Maven, unless you're in his hometown.
There are so many young kids like, thanks for spoiling it, Cornish.
Yeah. Then, speaking of Tough Enough, how about this moment? How about when you had Daniel Puter after the year that he won, and they just threw him to the wolves with Benoit Guerrero and Bob Holly for like 10 minutes.
I know that is technically a Tough Enough, but I don't consider that like a real Tough Enough. But yeah, Puter was the only thing memorable about that cluster of a Tough Enough.
The Miz came out of that. Ryback came out of that, so that's memorable,
I guess. What about the kid Levi who won the last season of Tough Enough? Remember him?
Oh, yeah.
That was a fun thing because of Steve Austin, because they let him cut a promo on everyone who was leaving. Yeah. And I thought that was the coolest thing. So the Rumble is on the way. We're going to give you our official predictions for all the matches on Thursday. Yes. And this is the best time of year for wrestling fans. From the Rumble through WrestleMania, this is just wrestling season.
And I think it's still very up in the air as to what happens this year. So it remains to be seen. And we will keep you up on all of it right here.
Of course.
The only place you can find it, the Enhancement Talent.